Welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name's Graeme Thomas. I'm a technical director here at BlastOne, and today we're going to discuss techniques and tips for broadcasting aggregates into coatings to make them non-slip. The first principle is that we need the grain to sit into wet coating. And if I'm going onto concrete, the absorption of the concrete varies. So I need to seal it first. So the grains go into the second coat. On steel, it's a little different, but the challenge is if the grain goes into the first coat on the steel that's unprimed, it's going to make a holiday because it's going to go right through to the steel and potentially give you a weak point. So we would always recommend that the granules go into the second coat. They're never put into a first coat. The first coat can just be a seal on concrete, so it's quite thin, but get it sealed so the absorption is gone, and then you can get a nice good coat on to broadcast your grains. You should always then put a third coat over the top, and that locks it in and encapsulates the grain and stops them being kicked out when someone walks on it. So it's really, really hard to do it with less than a three coat system. If we're using a granule filled coating, which has the very high volumes, it is again extremely important that it goes into the second coat, not the first coat. And the way it works in this type of coating is we get a seal first, and then I need a very even second coat. And then we broadcast the granules until we cannot see any coating, and they absorb the coating, they suck it up until the coating can't be seen. We come in the next day and we sweep off any loose coating and put another coat on top. That gives you a fully grain-filled coating, which is very impact resistant and is often seen in specifications on things like ship decks, helicopter landing spaces, maybe on a building. They want a grain-filled coating, they want the ultimate performance and extreme slip resistance. The next question is how to actually spread them. And there's three things we see done. For applications where that are small and potentially complex, you always use a handheld bucket with a small amount of grain in it, and you spread it by throwing it in the air as if you are feeding the chooks, we used to say. That's chickens for other people on the globe, or hens or roosters, but we in Australia, we call them chooks. If you've got large areas to do, we use a texture gun, a hopper gun, which is used to spray texture coatings on drywall, and you put the granules in there and spray them out just with that manual gun. And for even larger projects, we can adapt a blast pot to do it. We've done all these techniques many times, depending on the type of grain and the amount of the project. So coating selection for broadcasting non-slip is very important. The first coat, which is a seal coat, does not matter as long as it meets the specification for the client and is suitable for the substrate. But the second coat is very important. It has to stay wet long enough for the grains to sink into it. So we're looking for very high solids coatings that are relatively slow drying. It gives you the most open work time and means that corners and doorways won't be dried out and will lose the grains that stick. The alternative is if we're looking to get this surface back into service very fast, is you have to do it in very small sections. If you can do the large section in one operation, it's best. And you can walk on the coating with a set of golf or spike shoes so that you don't make footprints as you work and spread the grains. But if you have to do it in small sections, it's very important that you don't spread the grains all the way to your wet edge that you're applying the coating, because you'll get a visible line then where the grains stop. So you leave a margin of 3 feet or a meter of uncoated material, uncoated surface, and you do that in the next run as you do it section by section. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. See you next week.